The world of science is in the midst of an accelerated changing of paradigms. What I mean by paradigm is a set of metaphysical assumptions or a worldview by which all subsequent observations and reasoning are interpreted. Physics is what we think about. Metaphysics is how we think about it. For example, for the past two centuries, scientists have assumed that the present is the key to the past. Before that, they assumed that the past was the key to the present. The assumptions are a free choice. The consequences are not. We're mostly unaware of the paradigms that shape the way we think, and when they change, we become confused. We begin to doubt values and ideas that we've taken for granted. We begin to recognize falsifying evidence. We begin to consider alternative explanatory ideas. Familiar relationships fall apart. We no longer know what to think. Metaphysics overshadows physics. With the previous worldview in doubt, we have few benchmarks to judge new ideas. As with beginning to assemble a jigsaw puzzle from a pile of pieces, we must push pieces around to find what fits. We need to play with them. I'll use as an example the differences between the electric universe, EU model of cosmology, and the standard model. The EU model assumes that electricity and plasma ideas are the most important for explanatory purposes. The standard model assumes that gravity and gas ideas are the most important. Discussions of the differences between the models often seem confused by lack of clarity in how we think about the ideas. Some of it seems to arise from imprecision in the use of such words as observations, data, evidence, facts, and theories. People tend to use those words interchangeably, but they can be applied more carefully to mark distinctions in the process of knowing. I think of observations as groups of nerve activations and data as strings of electrical on-off signals without interpretation by some theory. They are the immediate responses of detectors, whether biological or electronic, to stimuli. Noting the colors of a traffic light and holiday lights, or the number a meter needle points to, are all observations. Evidence is a group of observations or data selected to be relevant to a preconceived but evolving idea of the phenomenon that's of interest. Evidence is ambiguous. It can be relevant to several different phenomena, and its meaning will be different with each one. Observations of red light are relevant both to traffic signals and to holiday lights, but you won't get a ticket for not stopping at the Christmas tree. Still, evidence isn't arbitrary. A light is red and not green. A meter needle points to 3 and not to 8. Facts are evidence interpreted by a theory. The theory provides the meaning. With a theory of traffic signals, red means stop. With a theory of circuits, a meter reading of 3 means 3 volts. Evidence tells you that something is. Theory tells you what something is. Facts make sense of evidence. A theory is a set of interrelated ideas that are constrained and shaped by facts, but that also define and determine what facts are. Theories and facts are interrelated. Facts can't exist apart from the theory that they support and that also gives them meaning. This is what is meant by the phrase, facts are theory-laden. Conversely, theories are fact-laden. These are not independent processes, but different emphases on a single evolving process of making sense that's circular, iterative, and reflexive. Making is a creative act that involves imaginative interpretation. It's an intrinsic aspect. Making sense is not simply seeing what's naively there. A successful making results in a narrative or story that is coherent, consistent, and corresponds with the theory's interpretation of the selected evidence. These definitions are soft. They add clarity to the usual vagueness, but don't entirely eliminate it. Additional confusion arises from thinking that electric universe ideas are simply added on to accepted ideas of what's called the standard model. This has been called the inertia of prior belief. Rather, EU ideas are founded on different selections of observations and data, different evidence, and different interpretations of evidence, different facts. We observe lights. We select for our evidence the ones in the sky that appear to move around the Earth. We call them stars. Before Newton, the interpretation that made sense of this evidence was that the stars moved in perfect circles in the perfect heavens by their intrinsic nature. After Newton, the idea of gravitational force replaced that geometric idea. With gravity, things have an intrinsic property of mass, whose nature is to attract other mass with an inverse square of the distance relationship. With ideas of electrically active plasma, things have an inherent property of charge, whose nature is to attract opposite charge and to repel like charge while inducing spin. Mixing these ideas is like mixing water and dirt. You get mud. The EU model has a different cognitive framework from Newtonian and relativistic mechanics. We must unlearn several assumptions that we usually take for granted without being aware of them. We presume that space is dark and empty, or practically so. It's empty because it's dark. We don't sense anything, so there must not be anything there. But now that scientists have invented sensors that detect stimuli outside our biologically limited ranges, radio, infrared, ultraviolet, X-ray, and gamma ray telescopes, and so on, we know that space is full and bright. It's full of radiating plasma. The inertia of prior belief leads us to think that the few atoms and particles in space behave as a familiar gas. We take it for granted that mass and velocity are the important parameters and movements are determined by collisions. But a century of experimentation with plasma has shown that the primary characteristics are electromagnetic, Birkeland currents, double layers, cell formation, pinch effects, sorting of constituents, multiple velocities, evolving instabilities, electrically versus thermally generated radiation. We never question that the weak force of gravity dominates. But again, both lab experiments and observations in space have shown that plasma forces can be many orders of magnitude greater than those of gravity and gas. For example, the arms of spiral galaxies should show that the stars move more slowly with distance from the center if they are orbiting a central gravitating mass. Doppler evidence shows them to have about the same velocity, as if the galaxy were being stirred from the edge. One EU model speculation is that a galaxy is a transverse pinch in a giant intergalactic Birkeland current with multiple filaments. The filaments twist around the axis, and their location around the periphery of the galaxy drives its rotation. It's more like an electric motor than a mechanical clock. Markland convection builds up quasi-neutral plasma that spirals away from the peripheral filaments. The increased ion and current densities push the plasma into glow mode and generate stars in secondary pinches. Think of a ring galaxy with somewhat evenly spaced hot spots, hydrogen 2 regions, near the edge. The hot spots would be where the filaments cross the intergalactic pinch plane. Keep in mind that this is a simplistic illustration for the purpose of contrasting an idea of electrically driven, far from equilibrium, resonant motion with the unquestioned idea of inertial gravitational rotation at energy equilibrium. Real galaxies are surely more complex. We also take for granted that equilibrium conditions prevail, fully specifiable and represented mathematically with continuous functions. In contrast, plasma conditions are often far from equilibrium and discontinuous. An excess of energy flows through active plasma, and some of it is dissipated in the evolving instabilities and radiation. Conditions are better represented by the mathematics of complexity, with discontinuities, bifurcations, resonant states, and emergent orders. The EU model is not the standard model of a four-dimensional nonlinear geometry, relativity, or a differential calculus of continuous variables, Newtonian mechanics, and ideal gas theory. It's not the hypothetical and metaphorical abstractions of mathematical model making. It's observed behavior, putting the empirical back in empirical method. And it's not a finished theory. Only a handful of experimenters have been looking into the nature of plasma for scarcely a century, and their investigations are also permeated with the vagueness I'm describing. The unconscious assumptions of familiar gravity and gas thinking prejudice everyone's judgment and often can only be corrected over time by trial and error processes. The EU model is a work in progress.